Hi, and welcome to this training video, where I will show you how to install Simplicity Studio, as well as walk you through some of the most important use cases. You begin by downloading the Simplicity Studio installer from scilabs.com and start it. During the installation, you will be given the choice of where you want to install Simplicity Studio, but for this demonstration, I will just install it to the default directory. As the installer only includes Simplicity Studio itself, you will need to install additional packages once you start up Simplicity Studio for the first time. You are then given four options of what you want to install. The full installation gives you everything, all documents, all tools for all the part families. Note that this requires quite a lot of data to be downloaded and installed on your computer. So if you don't need everything, you can choose to install a subset by only installing packages for the 8051 products or for the EFM32 products. The last option allows you to select a custom set of packages for more fine-grained control of the installation. You can choose which products to install, either by family on this page, or you can go to the Customize menu and select individual part numbers you want to support. If you already have a Silicon Labs kit at hand, you can connect this to your computer using a USB cable and then click Select Connected. Simplicity Studio will then check what kind of part is on this kit and then only install the packages that are needed to support this part. On the next page, you will be able to select which of the tools you want to install, including the Simplicity Studio IDE and other tools. When you go to the next page, you will be shown an overview of all the packages that you have selected. Here you can make more adjustments if needed. If you then click Finish, it will install the packages that you have selected. But in this case, I will just go back and use the full installation instead. The download will then take a while, depending on how many packages you have chosen to install. When the download is finished, you will be asked to restart Simplicity Studio so it can reconfigure itself. Then when Simplicity Studio starts up again, you will be asked if you want to install the drivers for the Silicon Labs kits. Press yes to this and follow the installation. When you've finished the driver installation, Simplicity Studio will check to see if you have any other IDEs installed that are supported by Simplicity Studio. If this is the case, you'll be asked to choose which of these is your preferred IDE. In this case, I have both Kyle and IR in addition to the Simplicity IDE that comes with Simplicity Studio. On the left-hand side, you find the product selection section. Here you have three main ways of selecting which part you want to work with. If you already know what device you're looking for, you can find it by typing in the part number in the product search box. Once the part is selected, you will see some more information about this device, including the core, the flash and RAM size, number of digital IOs, and some of the peripherals. There are also buttons that allow you to easily access the online store where you can get samples and kits. At the bottom of the left-hand side, you will find links to the reference manuals, datasheets, and errata sheet for the device that you have selected. If you're not sure exactly what part you're looking for, you can use the parametric search to find the part that fits your needs. You can choose what kind of core you want, the amount of flash and RAM you need, the number of digital IOs that you want in your package, and the size of the package. You can also choose between a range of analog and digital peripherals. When you've made your selection, the tool will present you with a list of all the parts that fit this description. The last way of selecting a device is by connecting a kit to your computer. Simplicity Studio can then detect all connected kits, and you'll be able to choose the part that is on this kit that you have connected. You can now see that I connect to a Giant Gecko kit, and this immediately updates to a Giant Gecko 990 device. In the Tools section of Simplicity Studio, you will find the link to your preferred IDE, which in this case is set to Simplicity IDE. There's also a link to the Energyware Profiler, to the Energyware Designer, to the Energyware Battery Estimator, and the Energyware Commander. On the right-hand side, you can find a demo menu that allows you to easily load in demos for the kit that you have connected. Below, on the Software and Kits line, you will find a link to the software documentation that allows you to easily code using emlib and all of the drivers for the EFM32 parts. When I click on the Software Examples button, it will already have selected the kit and the part that is selected in Simplicity Studio. When I click on Next, it will show me a list of all of the demos that are available for this kit. When I select the demo and click Next, I will be able to choose a name for a temporary copy of this demo. When I click Finish, it opens up the source code for this demo in my preferred IDE, which in this case is set to Simplicity IDE. I will close the IDE and instead go back to Simplicity Studio and have a look at the application notes. When I click on the application notes, I see a whole list of application notes and I can see a small description of each one. At the top, I can also type in a filter text. Typing in UART shows all the app notes that have something to do with UART. When I select an application note, I can click on Open to open the PDF document, I can open the folder, or I can open the project in an IDE. In this case, there are several projects included in the app notes, so I have to select which one I want to open. And again, it opens up in Simplicity IDE. The next link in Simplicity Studio is the kit documentation link. Here you can find all the documentation for all the kits that are supported by Simplicity Studio. In this case, I want to take a look at the user manual for the Giant Gecko Starter Kit. On the bottom line of Simplicity Studio, you can find a link to the Silicon Labs webpage. On the next button, you will find all of the presentations and brochures for the different products. In this case, I'm showing a brochure for the EFM32 parts. If you need any help or inspiration, you can also find links to the Silicon Labs community and technical support on the bottom. If you need any training, you can click on the University button, where you will find several training modules on how to use the EFM32 parts. They include PDF documents, as well as hands-on training exercises. On the right-hand side, you have a link to the YouTube channel for Silicon Labs. If at any time you need to remove some packages or install some new ones, you can find the Install Packages menu on the top right-hand corner. When packages for completely new tools or documents are published, this is where you'll find them. By default, Simplicity Studio connects to the internet to check if there are any new packages available every time you start it up. But you can manually check for updates by clicking on the Check for Updates button. If at any time you need to change your preferred IDE, you can do that in the Settings menu. In this case, I will change my preferred setting to IAR Embedded Workbench. We see now that the IDE link is then changed to IAR Embedded Workbench. If I go to Software Examples and click Next, and then open up the Blink project, this now opens up in IAR Embedded Workbench. Keep in mind that any third-party IDEs need to be installed separately. So that was all I had to show you for this introduction video of Simplicity Studio. Now you can go to scilabs.com and download your own copy and try it all out for yourself.